math ain't about numbers. If you think math is about numbers, you probably think that Shakespeare is all about words. You probably think that dancing is all about shoes. You probably think that music is all about notes. Math ain't about numbers. Math is about logic. It's about beauty. It's about connections. It's about how you get from one place to another. And for me, the cool thing about math is a part of it called topology. I'm not even going to tell you about topology because what I'm interested in is a little section of topology called non-orientable manifolds. More specifically, I'm interested in Klein bottles. This is a Klein bottle. Wait a second. We haven't even touched upon a Mobius loop. How can I talk about a Klein bottle without talking about a Mobius loop? I take a piece of paper. As everybody knows, if I have this piece of paper, it has two sides, four edges. Turn it around this way, it becomes a cylinder. Give it a half twist, and a piece of tape becomes a Mobius loop. Well, the cool thing about a Mobius loop, and there's about 50 or 60 cool things about a Mobius loop, is that it's got one side, it's got one edge. Take two Mobius loops, one a left-handed one, the other a right-handed one, and I try to connect them. Hey, this one has one edge, this one has one edge. What happens if I take two Mobius loops and sew their edges together? Well, I know from experience that if I have four edges here and four edges here and I connect them, oh, I'll get something that has fewer edges. So if I apply that to a Mobius loop, I've got one edge here, sew them together, I should get something that has, oh, I'd lose this edge, I'd lose that edge, I ought to have something with no edges. Cool. If I take two Mobius loops, hook them together, I'll get something without any edges. Okay, I'm going to try it. Hot damn! Far out. Here's a Mobius loop. Here's another Mobius loop. The cool thing is that if I take two Mobius loops and try to sew them together, I end up with a shape that requires four spatial dimensions to exist. And that shape is called a Klein bottle, named after Felix Klein. Felix Klein, this guy in 1882, came up with the absolutely nifty idea that if you can take a cylinder, turn it around, and orient one end of it, and loop it through, so his idea was take a cylinder, bring it through itself, and have the end of the cylinder welded to the base, that this would have the cool property of having only one side. Well, what do I mean by one side? If I have an ant crawling around here, ant or caterpillar crawls around, oh, clearly it can cover this whole thing. It can then slide continuously over there through this tube and get to the other side of this piece of glass. We never cross an edge to get to the inside. Absolutely nifty. In an ordinary, let me get an ordinary bottle. Ordinary bottle. Well, if I leave the cap on the bottle, clearly it has two sides. Here's an outside, and the inside of the bottle is where I'm touching right now. An ant walking around here couldn't get to the other side. If I take the top off, watch this. An ant walking along here can get to the other side, but he has to cross a peculiar location called an edge. If I make this bottle arbitrarily thin, this edge becomes sharp, and the ant cuts herself when she tries to walk from the outside to the inside. In other words, an ordinary bottle has two sides, an outside that I'm touching and an inside that my finger is touching right now. And they're separated by the lip of the bottle. And okay, we all know this. A Klein bottle, meanwhile, watch this. You can walk around here just like walk around here, but the other side of my finger I can get to without ever crossing a sharp edge. By carefully walking along, never crossing an edge, going through this tube and getting to the place that's just on the other side of my finger without ever crossing an edge. In other words, this is a bottle without an edge.
If I'm comfortable with that, except you just told me that this wasn't possible in three dimensions.
If we lived in a universe with four spatial dimensions, four space, this tube wouldn't have to intersect itself. this weird place where there's self-intersection, right there, that would not self-intersect. And an ant walking along this way would go boop, 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 and go right through this piece of glass here and keep walking to the inside. And an ant walking around this way would go right through this and keep walking this way.
Cliff, that hole that you've created there so the tube can get through is like the floor.
This is worse than the floor. It's this place right here where the manifold, where the glass intersects itself. It's a figment of living in a three-dimensional universe. If we lived in four space, we could go right through. On the other hand, that guy Felix Klein showed that in three dimensions, you have to have this intersection. In a quality universe that has four spatial dimensions, Klein bottles would be terrific. Here, unfortunately, my Klein bottles have to have this self-intersection. When I make Klein bottle hats, right, here's a hat that is the same thing as that glass Klein bottle. Instead of welding it together, I've knitted this hat so that the peak of the hat comes through itself, so that the hat itself can, the loop of the hat can be pulled through itself and turn it inside out. But I'd rather not do this because it takes about 5 minutes to do and I'm stretching things that shouldn't be stretched. But ultimately, I ought to be able to pull this sort of inside out, sort of. It's continuously deformable back to itself.
Cool.
And along with a matching Mobius scarf. Ah! I'd like to say I'm ready for a California winter. Look, 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 look! Friend of mine, Robert Lang, made a paper origami Klein bottle. I mean, absolutely sweet. One sheet of paper, it's an origami Klein bottle. One of the neat things about mathematical topology is that you don't care what size something is. I can expand this, contract it. I can make this, I can stretch it, and it'll still have the same mathematical properties. Same number of sides, same number of holes, same number of handles. Instead of making a big one, I could make it smaller. I could make an even smaller Klein bottle. I mean, I can make a Klein bottle even smaller. To a mathematician, these are all the same thing. And, of course, I can go in the other direction as well. I can make them big. So I had to put 1,000 Klein bottles someplace, so I put them under my house. And the wheels, you know, they're little motors drive the wheels around.